Hello. Hello, and welcome to Adrianne's kitchen. It's sort of like pre-kitchen because we're not doing the cooking yet. We're doing the prep work, which is get yourself a spaghetti squash and stab it a bunch of times. Be super careful when you're using a sharp knife so you don't hurt yourself. Anyways, stab your squash so it has a bunch of vent holes, and then you're going to put it into a baking dish, and you are going to bake that at 400 for about 45 minutes. And then you're going to let it cool down because it's going to be hot. Like burn your fingertips hot. But eventually you're going to cut it in half, and then you're going to scoop out the gross stuff, and then you're going to fork it into spaghetti-like noodles. Tonight, when we do start cooking and I go through the rules of wash your hands, blah, 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 all that stuff, you'll see we're going to make chicken Alfredo spaghetti squash featuring broccoli. While that spaghetti squash cooks, maybe you've been wondering, Adrianne, tell me, how did you get all this produce? How do you still have produce on hand? Great question. I have good friends that bring produce to the north. The produce has been pretty sad and picked over where I live, and I can understand why. Plus, the grocery store that we have in town is already limited, and their produce has not been great in general. And I am so lucky to have a friend who is approximately 45 minutes from where we live. That's where they're currently staying. And they have agreed to meet me in an undisclosed location to drop off the goods. That's right, we're waiting to make a deal. AKA, I'm paying her for some produce. She's entering. She's coming in. She's gonna drop it off. Woo! We're gonna have to maintain 6 feet of distance. We're gonna see how this trade goes. Guys, we got the goods. We got the goods. Plus, she's so kind. She got me a block of cheese and some chocolate. Here we go. Gotta go make dinner now. Okay. Now that we have picked up the goods, and our spaghetti squash has already been cooked, we are ready to begin. Rosa is joining us. She is very angry because she knows there's cheese and she's not getting any. So let's get started. As always, I washed my hands as step number one. Step number two, I got my apron on. I'm pretty sure you saw it in the first part. And step number three, I do have a beverage. Chicken. It's got the saran wrap. You see the mallet. You know what's about to go down here. I'm going to flatten that chicken because you want your chicken. Say it with me. Flat, not fat. We've got a bowl of broccoli. I'm lazy. I'm doing frozen broccoli. It's not just laziness. It's that I didn't have any fresh broccoli and the stores are out. So frozen broccoli it is. We'll just microwave that to heat it up a little bit before I put it in the pan. And then I have a lot of freshly shredded Parmesan cheese, which is going to go on top. I am not making my own Alfredo sauce tonight, but you can definitely do that. Butter, heavy cream, and Parmesan is the way to go. I have plenty of Parmesan to make that happen if I wanted. But we're not going that route tonight, because we're going to do classico, all sorts of seasonings. So, let's get this started. You can go harder than that. That's right. Okay. Be kind, but take it out. Beat the shit. Yeah! Get the chicken! Okay, this time I remembered to season the chicken instead of seasoning the pan. I threw some olive oil in the pan and then probably I'd say about 2 tablespoons of garlic and let that start to sizzle up. And then I seasoned my chicken with salt, pepper, onion powder, and a little dash of paprika, which is exactly why I didn't use all my paprika in my Creole seasoning the other night. But, anywho, dash of paprika just to add a little spice to our upcoming Alfredo. We're just going to let this chicken cook, and in the meantime, we'll take care of that spaghetti squash. So I had a squash which was whole. Now it is half, and it's cooked. This is a scoop loop brought to you by Pampered Chef, one of my favorite purchases. I believe it was $5 at the time, but inflation, I'm sure it went up. I don't have a Pampered Chef dealer, so I don't have anyone to suggest to you, but you're going to use the scoop loop to kind of get all of those seeds right out of the middle there, as you can see. My squash is, sorry about my trash too, guys. It's a terrible view, but you gotta get those seeds out somewhere. All right, seeds
look to be. It's like core section here.
Yep, yep. Get that out. And then we'll just set that in there for now. We will take a fork to it. And as you can see here, it just looks like a spaghetti noodle, except it's squash and it's delicious. It's got a very different texture than noodle, obviously, and then it doesn't taste like spaghetti because it's not wheat, but or grain of any type, but it's very tasty, and it is definitely a better alternative if you're going to be low carb, like I am. One full squash, like a good size one, I would say produces enough for a family of four to six. It depends on the size of squash you get, because depending on the season and depending on availability in your area, you might end up with a really small squash. I had like the saddest spaghetti squash like a month ago. It was a sad day, but it fed us for a night. So I'm gonna just stir up the spaghetti squash so that way it's ready to go for when that chicken's done.
Perhaps you recall me saying, when you cook your chicken, walk away.
Walk away.
Because otherwise you just stare at your chicken the whole time. So I'm waiting for that chicken to cook up. Cheers. Having myself a drink tonight. Also, composting on my to-do list. So if you were wondering, why was I throwing away the middle of that spaghetti squash when I could totally just compost it? You're totally right. I could. That's on our to-do list to get done. Now that we're in quarantine, we have all the time to get a compost set up. So maybe that'll happen in the upcoming days. Also, I just wanted to get a little cereals to try back out from the other day. Every day is different. Some days I'm not okay. Some days I'm okay with everything that's going on. And today was definitely a much better day for my own mental health. Yesterday there was a lot of ups and downs and taking 5-minute breaks to just kind of cry and feel whatever I was feeling. And, I'm glad that I opted to do that because today I definitely feel better and it's been 2 nights without any COVID dreams. So that is a win. I think I should go check on that chicken though. All right. Pulled that chicken off as a reminder. 165. That's your chicken temp to make sure nobody gets sick. Microwave the broccoli so that way it's not frozen. And I'm going to throw that into the pan. I reduced it to low. It's still going to sizzle like mad. Yep, that's what I thought. I'm just going to mix that in real quick. This is going to add some of that flavor from the garlic that was in the oil. And then I'm going to throw in the spaghetti squash. One-handed! Woo! Got it. And then we're going to toss it up a bit just to mix that broccoli in. The hard part with some spaghetti squash sometimes, I just realized I'm not giving you the right angle. My bad. Hard part with some spaghetti squash sometimes is that the squash will actually turn out squashy instead of stringy. And so you don't want to overcook it, but you also like don't want to undercook it either because then you won't end up with any strings. So while we've got the broccoli and the squash mixed in, time for some classico for cheese Alfredo. And then I'm going to cut the chicken. Stay tuned. Voila! I sliced up that chicken, mixed it in with the squash and the sauce, and then I sprinkled with some of that delightfully freshly grated Parmesan. And that's how you end up with spaghetti squash chicken Alfredo. Featuring broccoli. Y'all have a great night. Love ya. See ya.
10 out of 10. Best meal I've ever had.
Thanks, babe.